Hey, what's up, guys? Tyler here with Secure Team. Today, I want to talk about a very interesting discovery that may give us that much more proof that human beings, and I'm talking about people just like you and me, lived millions, possibly hundreds of millions of years ago, and that reinforces the theory, which I've been leaning towards for a while now, which is that the history of Earth is cyclical. Now, cyclical, of course, means recurrent, or something that occurs in cycles, meaning that humans have been here, we've evolved, we had reached our limit in intelligence and technology before something wiped us out. Either it was us, an asteroid, whatever your theory, but we have been here multiple times and have risen from the ashes multiple times. And so the discovery I want to talk about today is this what's said to be an ancient shoe print that was discovered imprinted in a fossilized rock back in 1917. It's also known as the Fisher Canyon footprint. And so the story goes, and according to the very first reports of this, and there are actually two reports. One was in March of 1922 in the New York Times, and another 1922 article in the American Weekly section of the New York Sunday American, where it was described that while prospecting for fossils in Nevada, a man by the name of John T. Reed, who is a distinguished mining engineer and geologist, stopped suddenly and looked down in utter bewilderment and amazement at a rock near his feet. For there, a part of the rock itself was what seemed to be a human footprint. Closer inspection showed that it was not a mark of a naked foot, but was apparently a shoe sole, which had been turned into stone. The forepart was missing, but there was an outline of at least two-thirds of the shoe, and around this outline ran a very well-defined sewn thread, which had, it appeared, attached the welt to the sole. Further on was another line of sewing, and at the center where the foot would have rested had the object really been a shoe sole, there was an indentation, exactly such as would have been made by the bone of the heel rubbing upon and wearing down the material. Now, some have dated this shoe print to be upwards of 200 million years old. Others have deemed it to be maybe 5 to 10 million years old. But regardless of the age here, what we do know is that humans, according to science today and everything we know, or at least what we're told in the mainstream, is that humans did not exist millions of years ago. At the most, we're said that they existed maybe hundreds of thousands, but not millions, and especially not hundreds of millions back during the days of the dinosaurs. So an analysis was done of the shoe print through microscopic photography that was carried out later on by the Rockefeller Institute. It was confirmed to the cries of skeptics and those who said, oh, it's nothing but a natural rock. It was found that it was indeed a heel, and that the fossil seemed to show the presence of two rows of stitching, 8.5 millimeters apart, with the twists in the thread clearly visible. Minute crystals of mercury sulfide were also confirmed, which solidified the fossil's antiquity. Even the head of the Museum of Archaeology in Oakland, California, finally had to buckle under the pressure of all of this evidence to come out and finally state, quote, "Today's people on the earth are not yet able to make this kind of shoe. Facing this kind of evidence indicates that at the time of suspected uncivilized anthropods millions of years ago, people with high intelligence appear to have existed. The minutest detail of thread, twist, and warp proves that the shoe sole is strictly the handiwork of man." It was also noted that the right side appeared to be more worn down than the left, indicating that the shoe was worn on the right foot. The whereabouts of the fossil today are unknown. However, this is not the first time that a shoe print has been discovered fossilized in a rock. Far from it, in fact. For we had another discovery, where in this footprint, it was found that an ancient species called the trilobite had been embedded in the print itself. Now, trilobites are known to have existed between 280 and 320 million years ago. And so a local rock hound by the name of William J. Meister was hunting for trilobites along a hillside near Antelope Springs, Utah in 1968, when he broke open a slab and discovered something curious, an oblong shape that took the form of a human sandal print, along with several fossilized remains of small trilobites. Dr. Melvin A. Cook, who is a renowned chemist at the University of Utah, has confirmed the authenticity of the sandal print, saying, quote, "Quite obviously, this footprint could not be the result of any carving, since until found, it was covered by the strata above." Finally, we have this fossilized shoe print here that was discovered by a school teacher in Urumqi City in 1977. Where once again we have a 10-inch shoe print that is clearly visible, and on the heel portion of said print was found a prehistoric codfish fossil about 5 inches long. And so you put all of this evidence together, and you say to yourself, okay, one shoe print could be natural, but two, and then three? And then we have to take into consideration all of the other so-called forbidden artifacts that have been discovered over the years, and we're talking about artifacts that are either man-made or artificial that have been found fossilized in rocks and lumps of coal that date back hundreds of millions of years. Things like the Klerksdorp spheres, which were these small metallic-looking balls that were discovered by miners in South Africa that, despite being perfect spheres, are detailed with an inscription of these perfect lines wrapping around the centers of each one, discovered in rocks that were dated back 3 billion years. Then we have something called the Ica stones, which are arguably the worst nightmare an archaeologist could have ever digged out of the ground. And as you can see here, discovered in Peru in the 1960s, were these set of beautifully crafted and revealing stones, covered in drawings indicating that dinosaurs coexisted with humans and modern technology. Then we have ancient discoveries like tools and machinery parts, such as this shiny metal bar with what looks like teeth spanning its top portion, discovered in a chunk of black rock dating back some 300 million years old. In 1851, an Illinois Springfield Republican reported that a businessman named Hiram D. Witt had found a fist-sized chunk of quartz while on a trip to California. When it accidentally slipped from his hands, it split open and out fell out an iron-cut nail. The quartz was said to be about 1 million years old. In 1961, the owners of a gift shop in Olancha, California, found a fossil-encrusted geode in the Coso Mountains. When one of the owners cut the geode in half with a diamond saw, he discovered an object inside that was obviously artificial. The object had a metal core surrounded by layers of ceramic-like material and a hexagonal wooden sleeve. When X-rayed, the object seemed to resemble a modern spark plug or some other electric component. It had been completely encased in a geode that was covered with fossils estimated to be 500,000 years old. And so these forbidden artifacts go on, and I'll post a link in the video description where you can read about some more. But back to the shoe print here, I think it's an amazing discovery. Despite what the skeptics say, and I do believe, and the evidence shows that there is a clear agenda here with mainstream scientists and archaeologists who want to keep this information covered up because they have their own set theory and sequence of events that they have worked very hard to convince us of and to procure funding for. And so any deviations in that, such as these forbidden artifacts, throw a wrench into what we know about modern archaeology and the history of the Earth. And for that reason, the speaking about these artifacts will likely forever be forbidden. So with that, let me know what you guys think. Thanks for stopping by today, and I gotta say, we are very close to 1 million subscribers. It's totally awesome. Thank you guys again. I love you all. Be sure to stay tuned. I've got a lot more coming, and I will see you back in just a bit. Stay safe, guys.